Hello and welcome back. This is Katie Colleen and I am doing another tutorial of my BB-8 original design kimono. In this tutorial I'll be doing the kimono top and skirt. If you didn't see my previous tutorial, it was on how to do all the applique designs in this costume, and I'll link that in the description down below. For this costume I used 100% cotton for both the white fabric and the gray and the orange contrasts. I mainly went off this McCall's pattern here for the kimono. I did make a few adjustments. I lengthened the skirt by 5 inches in order to fit the BB-8 circle designs. Additionally, I didn't like how they did the fasteners. I personally don't like Velcro and don't entirely trust snaps. So for this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I fastened everything with ties instead, which I trust a lot more. From the white fabric, I cut out the skirt. And I cut out the front and the back of the kimono, as well as these very large square sleeves. With that, I could begin sewing it together. I sewed together the back seam and the shoulder seams, and then I sewed together the skirt seams. The skirt I made also included 2 petticoat layers. There's only 1 in the pattern, but I had some extra fabric, and why not? It'll be extra poofy. So I decided to do 2 petticoats, 1 white and 1 orange. I did follow the pattern for the pettiskirt, however, I wish I had made it longer. I did add 5 inches to the outer skirt and I didn't add any length to the pettiskirt. Sew together both sides of the pettiskirt and then you can cut out the ruffles. Here I am doing a rolled hem on the edge of the ruffles so they won't fray. I felt this was better than having to fold it over and cut out twice as much fabric, which at this point I was having a fabric crisis and quickly running out of every color of cotton fabric I had. To make ruffles, after you do the rolled hem, you want to do a gathering stitch along the top and then a second gathering stitch. Make sure these gathering stitches don't cross because you want to be able to pull the ends. So, because you want to be able to pull those ends, make sure you leave a lot of space. An extra thread on both sides. You should now have 4 strings on each side of the ruffle, 2 for the upper thread and 2 for the lower thread from the bobbin. And now you can just take 2 of those threads, either both upper threads or both bottom threads, and you can pull on them, and this will just ruffle up the fabric. Since I was not done making ruffles quite yet, I decided to make ruffles for the outer skirt as well. With this, I did the same thing, just doing the 2 gathering stitches, or you can just do a really wide straight stitch for the ruffles on the outer skirt. I wanted to also add a trim. The way I did this is I still did both gathering stitches on the ruffle, or that wide straight stitch, leaving plenty of room so that you can pull on those threads and ruffle it, but don't ruffle it quite yet. Before I ruffled it, I sewed the trim, making sure I didn't stitch over any of my gathering stitches. You can go ahead and ruffle it with the trim on it. I was finally able to sew the ruffles onto the skirt. For this, I did a zigzag stitch. Then I took all 3 layers of the skirt. If you want to just follow the pattern, then you'd have 2 layers. And then I serged all 3 layers together and I did a zigzag stitch. Again, from the pattern, there was a casing included. So for this, I just folded it over, sewed and serged the ends, and then I could sew it onto my 3 skirt combination. Then you can take some elastic, and I just put a safety pin on the end of that elastic and I threaded it through the casing. Now with the skirt finished, we can move on to the kimono top. To start with the kimono top, I'm going to sew the front and the back together. So I have that back portion with the center applique and the 2 front flaps, and where the shoulder seam meets between these 2, I'm going to sew that together on both sides and then serge it. You're also going to want to sew your sleeves to this shoulder seam. So there will be a portion where the sleeves match up to where your shoulder seam is. That's the seam you want to sew. Now that the sleeve is attached to the rest of the kimono top, you can sew that very long seam from the waist up through the armpit and then down the sleeve length. Another thing to consider with this seam is how I've incorporated the ties for this costume. I took the idea for this from my gi uniform from when I did karate. And the way you do this is you'll have ties on the outside, and this way you can just tie the outside of your right to the inside of your left, and then the outside of your left to the outside of your right. And this actually works fairly well, and you can even do martial arts, and this will hold pretty well. So I knew I could trust this system. But this is something you're gonna have to take into consideration when you are doing that long side seam, because you want one tie facing on the inside and then one tie facing on the outside. After you've done this, then you can sew the bottom of the square, which is your sleeve. Now you have a good base for your kimono, and you can add the trim. What you're gonna do is you're gonna line it up, and you're gonna sew one side of the trim down to the kimono. And then this is just done so that you can flip that trim over and sew it down. With this, it helps to iron that trim so that it is already laying flat when you flip it over and sew it down, so you don't have to do an initial stitch and then a top stitch. You can just get it all done in one stitch. It also helps this to lay flat if after you do that first seam, you go ahead and press it down. Now you can do the trim for the front of the kimono going around the back of the collar. Remember to add those ties for the outside also so that you can tie them to the other ties that you did in the waist. For the belt, I didn't like the idea of using Velcro. I personally don't like Velcro that much, so I decided to use four ties, which would tie behind my back in almost a corset fashion, but not quite, because it's four individual ties tying to each other and there's no lacing. I used the belt pattern from the McCall's pattern that I showed earlier. I just sewed it the backs to the fronts, just as indicated in the pattern. Once I had this done, I decided to insert some stiffener. I chose a fairly thick stiffener. I didn't want it to wrinkle or anything, especially because I was planning on tying it rather tight with those strings in the back. After I'd inserted the stiffener, I decided I wanted to do a top stitch just to hold that stiffener in place. And later on, I'm going to go over this top stitch area with an applique stitch to give it an overall finished look. I just included those four little ties into that seam where I was sewing it together in the back. In addition to the belt, I also used a tie end, which I tied over the belt. This was done by taking a bunch of shorter strips of fabric, since at this point I was still having a fabric crisis, and sewing all of them together into this very long tie end. Mine was quite a bit longer than what the pattern suggested. So using those two very long tie ends, now I can sew those together on one side, and then for the second side, I just ironed it down so it would be easier to do a top stitch on it. And then I did the top stitch around the entire tie end, both the side that I had already sewed and flipped, and the side which I had not sewed at all. With the tie end, I wrapped it around my waist twice over the belt. This does also help keep that belt nice and tight. That concludes how I made the kimono top, the skirt, and the belt, and I hope you enjoyed this video. I'll be back with another video on how I styled the wig, did the big hair bow, and how I made my choker. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.